Hello students, today we are going to start with the second part of chapter number 11, force and pressure. In this part, we will be discussing about the types of force. Generally, the types of forces are classified as contact forces and non-contact forces. Contact forces are those forces which are exerted by one object on the other when they are in contact with each other. Means, to apply contact force, contact between two objects is necessary, and this contact forces can be further classified into two types. They are muscular force and force of friction, whereas the other force, that is non-contact force, are those forces which are exerted by one object on the other without any contact with each other. Means they can even exert a force on other object being at a distance from the other object, and such forces are magnetic force, electrostatic force and gravitational force. Now let us discuss contact force in little bit detail. Okay, so the first force in contact force is the muscular force, the force in which muscles of our body is used. Means the muscular force are the forces which are exerted by using the muscles of our body. Even in our daily activities, we use muscular force for various activities. For example, if you are opening a door, if you are lifting your bag, if you are picking your book, if you are running, if you are lifting something heavy, in all such activities, we are using our muscles. Apart from animals, even animals use their muscular force. Animals like bullocks, horses, camels, donkeys, elephants, etc. They all are used for transportation, and we know that they are used in carts. We have heard about camel cart, bullock cart, horse cart. Okay, so these animals use their muscular force to move those carts. Even if we are riding bicycles, we are pushing something, we are pulling something, we are actually using our muscular force, because to do all these activities we need to come in contact with the other object. Means if we want to pick up a bag, we have to touch the bag. It means we are in contact and we are using the muscular force to do that. Yeah, so that was about the muscular force. Now let's see the force of friction. Now what does this force of friction means? Force of friction is actually the force which opposes the motion of an object over a surface. As we know that whenever two objects are in contact and an object is in motion, then the surface always tries to stop that object. For example, a ball rolling on ground gradually slows down and comes to rest due to force of friction, and it actually acts between the surface comes into play when two objects are in contact. Hence, friction force has been covered under the contact force. Similarly, while riding a bicycle, if we will stop pedaling it, it gradually slows down and it will come to rest because of the force of friction acting between the tire of the, that is the wheel of the bicycle and the road. So this is how the friction force acts, and the force of friction always acts in the opposite direction of a moving object. Means it always tries to stop a moving object. Now let's move to the next topic, that is the non-contact force. In non-contact force, the first force that we will discuss is magnetic force. As we all are aware about the magnets, we know that magnets exert force on other magnets and even on the materials like ions. A magnet can repel or attract other magnet depending on the nearby poles, and it can attract the nails or the materials made up of iron. And all this can be done, all this attraction and repulsion takes place even from a distance. It means a magnet is able to apply a force of either attraction or repulsion even when it is at a distance. Hence it is classified under non-contact forces. Now let's discuss the next force, that is the electrostatic force. Okay, so it is the force exerted by a charged body. Here, you have to keep in mind the charged body. It is an important word here. We know that when a plastic scale, if it is rubbed on the dry hair and then it is brought near a small bits of paper, then the small bits of paper starts getting attracted towards that plastic scale. How it takes place? It is because the electrostatic force. Whenever a body is rubbed with some other body, there is a transfer of charges which makes the body to acquire a charge, and once the body gets charged, it can attract or repel the other body. Here we can see an example. In example 1 is a plastic straw charged by rubbing with paper attracts a suspended plastic straw. Here we can see that in this figure both the plastic straw are getting attracted with each other, while in second figure we can see that this second plastic straw is moving away from the first plastic straw, means it is repelling. So a repulsion and attraction both can occur in this electrostatic force. Now let's move to the next topic. Our next topic is gravitational force, and we all are aware about the gravitational force. It is a force exerted by the earth on all the objects, whether it is small or big, and it is always a force of attraction. It always pulls all the objects towards it. Means if a coin or a pen falls down, when it slips off our hand, it doesn't rush above in the sky, because the earth is always attracting everything towards it. Similarly, if we throw a ball upward, it again comes down because of gravitational force. Even the leaves and fruits that fall from the trees, they usually fall down to the ground. Water in the rivers always flows downward. So all this phenomena takes place because of the gravitational force, which is actually applied on all the objects present on the earth. Not even on the earth, it is also applied in the space. Even the sun applies gravitational force on all the celestial bodies and all our 8 planets. When earth applies gravitational force on moon, so each and every object almost applies the gravitational force. And this is a non-contact force, because a sun being at a very far distance from the earth, it is able to apply the gravitational force. Now you have few questions to solve.